Okay, class, today this is week number 2, the week of April 20th. This is lesson 1 for the week, and today we're going to be talking about repeating decimals to fractions. Now, you may think that, oh, Mr. Nash, we've already done this. No, this one is only where part of the decimal repeats. Okay, so let's kind of do a little review. It says last week we learned how to convert a terminating decimal, which is a decimal that stops, and a repeating decimal, if the whole decimal is repeating, back to its decimal equivalent. Okay, so if I have a terminating decimal, what do I do in order to turn it into a decimal, or turn it into a fraction, excuse me? Well, all you have to do is say it correctly using place value. So if I gave you something like 0.5, we would say that as 5/10. So we would write that as 5/10. Okay, and then of course we would have to simplify. This is one of the things that y'all were not doing very well last week on those lessons, because we've got to make sure that these two numbers simplify, okay, and make sure that this fraction is in simplest form. So this 5 and 10, we have to ask ourselves, do they have any numbers that I could divide both of them by? Okay, so in this one right here, I could divide this by 5, I could divide this 10 by 5, and I end up with 1/2. Okay, so we have to remember to do that. Okay, so we've got to remember to simplify. Okay, so for a terminating decimal, one that stops, all we have to do is say it correctly using place value. But what if I gave you a repeating decimal? Well, now we're talking about with this repeating decimal, if the whole thing repeats, what do we do? Okay, so take for example, if I gave you 0.54 and the whole thing repeats. Okay, so what we're going to do with this, it says we're going to place the decimal in the numerator. So I'm going to take that 54, I'm going to place that in the numerator. And then it says, and place a 9 in the denominator for each number that's repeating. So my 5 and my 4 are repeating, so I would put a 9 for both of those. And then we would try to simplify that. Okay, well, this one, the 5 and the 4 and the 99, they have a 9 in common. So I could divide those both by 9. Okay, so 54 divided by 9 gives me 6. 99 divided by 9 gives me 11. So that gives me 6/11 as my final simplified fraction. And that's what we've got to make sure that we're doing. We've got to make sure that we're simplifying our fractions. Okay, so let's just kind of practice that real quick just to kind of make sure. Okay, so in this one right here, okay, it is a terminating decimal because I see no bar. So we just say it correctly. In this one, we would say it is 45/100. So I would write it as 45/100. Now we have to try to determine, what do these two numbers have in common? Well, I could divide them both by 5, because this one ends with a 5 and this one ends with a 0. Okay, so that means I could divide them by 5. Okay, now if you can't remember how to, if you can't remember or have trouble with the division, then just go to a calculator and do your division. 45 divided by 5 gives us 9. Okay, so then we would have 9 here. Okay, and then we would do the same thing with 100. 100 divided by 5, and that should give us 20, and it does. Okay, so then we ask, does the 9 and the 20 have anything in common? Well, another way you could do this is write out all the factors. Write out all the things that will go into both of them. The 9, I've got a 1, I've got a 3, and a 9. Those are the three numbers that will go into 9. Well, 20, I've got a 1, a 2, a 4, a 5, a 10, and a 20. If the biggest number they have in common is 1, then I know my fraction is in simplest form. You've got to make sure you do that, otherwise I will take off points. Okay, and your fraction will not be, it's a correct fraction, but it's not written correctly. Okay, so it's kind of like saying go over there and spelling there, T-H-E-I-R. It's the right word, but it's not the right tense or not the right one. Okay, so we've got to make sure that we simplify them. Now, this 0.7 with a bar, well, the 0.7 with a bar, the whole thing repeats. So the rule is take the 7, put it on top, and for every number that repeats, you put a 9 on the bottom. And this one is already in simplest form. Now, the 7/45 with a bar, that means it's 0.745, 745, 745, and so on and so forth. Okay, the whole thing repeats, so we would write 7/45 on top. and we would put the 999 on bottom. Okay. Now, these numbers right here, I've tested this one already, and this one doesn't simplify. Okay. So we just kind of think about what could I divide them both by. Well, this one I know I could divide by, you know, nines, I could divide by threes. So we test each one for those same kinds of things. If you've done your due diligence, we won't have a problem. Okay. I'm not going to give you some really crazy one that you'll have to simplify. Now, what if I gave you problems like this? Because this is what we're talking about today. What if only part of the decimal repeats? Well, we've got some rules for this, and it's very similar to what we've already done, but our numerator changes, okay? And then we also add one number into the bottom, okay? So let's look at what our rule is. If we have a repeating decimal, and we want to change it to a fraction where only part of it repeats, here's what we're going to do. For the numerator, we're going to find the difference of the whole decimal part, the whole thing, and the number formed by the non-repeating digits of the decimal, okay? So, take for example this one down here. I've got 0.342 where only the 42 is going to repeat. So I'm going to take that entire decimal, the 342, and I'm going to subtract the number formed by the non-repeating digits. Well, in this particular case, I've only got a 3, so I'm going to subtract the 3 from that. So I will do 342 minus 3 to get 339 for my numerator. Now, for the denominator, what we're going to do is we're going to put a 9 for each repeating digit, which is something we're used to already, okay, and a 0 for each non-repeating digit, and we start with the 9s, okay? So in this particular one, I've got two digits that repeat, so I put a 99. I've got one digit that doesn't repeat, so I put a 0. So my decimal or my fraction that I end up with that would give me 0.342 with the 42 repeating is 339 divided by 990. Now, if you don't believe me, well, we just go test it. 339 divided by 990. And you'll notice right there, what am I getting in my decimal? 0.34242424242, and it works. It's amazing how it happens, but it does work every single time, okay? So let's go over this one more time, and then we'll practice it, and then I'll give you an assignment. It says for the numerator, you're going to find the difference of the whole decimal part and the number formed by the non-repeating digits of the decimal, okay? The denominator, you're going to put a 9 for each repeating digit, and a 0 for each non-repeating digit. So let's see if we can practice this. Okay, so it says, what if we have this decimal that's only partially repeating? Okay. So we take our 0.16 right here. Okay, so we're going to first find the numerator. So this one I'm going to take the 16, and I'm going to subtract from it the number formed by the non-repeating part, which in this case is 1. Okay, so my numerator for this particular fraction is going to be 15. 16 minus 1 is 15. And I'm going to put as my denominator, I've got one number that repeats and one number that doesn't repeat. We get a 90. So 15 over 90, I know I can divide both of those by 5. Okay, so 15 divided by 5, I can do that in my head, so I do 3. 90 divided by 5, I could do that in my head, but if I have a calculator, let's just go ahead and do that. 90 divided by 5, you find out that that's 18. So 3 over 18. Now, am I done? No, I'm not done. The 3 and the 18, they still have a 3 in common. So I can divide this by 3 and get 1. I can divide this 18 by 3 and get 6. So my finished fraction is 1 over 6. That is my simplified version. Okay, so let's try another one. Okay, so here we've got 0.45 and the 5 is repeating. So again, I'm going to take the entire decimal, I'm going to subtract from it the number formed by the non-repeating part. In this case, it's a 4. Okay, so that tells me that my numerator is going to be 41, okay, over, and then I've got one repeating digit and one non-repeating digit, so my denominator is going to be 90. And 41 over 90 doesn't have anything in common. They simplify. It's as simple as it'll get. Now, the question is, what if I have more than one number that doesn't repeat? What do I do then? Okay, so that's what this one is for. So in this one right here, we've got, okay, 345, so that's going to be our whole decimal part. And I'm going to subtract from that the number formed by the non-repeating part. So in this case, The non-repeating part is the 34. So I'm actually going to subtract 345 and 34. Okay, so I'm going to go to my calculator here. 345 minus 34. And I end up with 311. Okay, so 311 over, now for my denominator, I've got one number that's repeating and two numbers that aren't repeating. Okay, so 311 over 900, and again, 311 and 900, they do not simplify. I've tested it before. Okay, so then the last question we have is, okay, so let's try one more example here. Well, what if this 0 right here, instead of it being a 0, what if it were a 4? What if it were a decimal number that had a whole part to it? So what would I do then? Well, the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to change this decimal part into a fraction. So I'm going to take this number right here, and you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and only the 3, 4 is repeating. So I'm going to take the 1, 2, 3, 4, and I'm going to subtract from that the number formed by the non-repeating part. We don't worry about the 4 because the 4 is a whole part. Okay, so I put a 12 there, so because that's the number formed by that. My denominator is going to be, there's two numbers repeat, and there's two numbers that don't repeat. Okay, so that becomes my denominator. So 1, 2, 3, 4 minus 12. So let's go to the calculator. 1, 2, 3, 4 minus 12 gives me 1,222, I believe is what it was. Okay, so 1,222 divided by 9900. Now that one will simplify. Okay, so what could I divide them both by? I could divide them both by 2 at the start that I know. So take this 1222. Oops. Let's see if I can figure out where I'm at here. Okay, 1222 divided by 2. I know that's going to give me 611. So 611. And then I'm going to do the same thing to the 9900. 99, oops, one too many nines there. 00 divided by 2. Oops, I still have one too many. I end up with 4950. And then I believe that's as simple as it will get. Okay, now, just to test this, to see if this would actually give me 0.12343434, we go back to our calculator, type in 611, divided by, let's see, what was my 4950, 4950, and you look there, 0.12343434344, and so on and so forth. It's really kind of cool. Now, we've got to remember that since this one did have a 4 as a whole part, then I'm going to just stick a 4 back in front of it. And then that would be my finished fraction. Okay, so what I'm going to want you to do today for your assignment, okay, we're going to do 10 questions. Now, again, you've got a form that you're going to fill out with this. Okay, and all you're going to do is you're going to give me the fraction. Okay, so take, for example, this one right here is 6 or 0.06060606. So what we've been doing is you're going to take the number that the whole decimal, which is 06, and we're going to subtract from it the non-repeating part. Well, in this case, there aren't any non-repeating parts, so it's just 6. So it's just 6 on top. Okay, and then on the bottom, you're going to put a 9 for each repeating digit. There's 2 repeating digits and no non-repeating, so it's just 99. So 6 over 99, and then you simplify that. Okay, so 6 and 99, I can divide them both by 3. So I end up with 2 over 11. Okay. I'm dividing by 3. Sorry, 2 over 33. Okay, so 2 over 33 is my finished answer. So you will type that into the form as 2/33. Right, so that's what I'm looking for on this particular assignment. You'll notice that some of the ones down here on the bottom are partially repeat, which are the ones that we deal with all the time. So again, to kind of review this, what do? For your numerator, you're going to find the difference of the whole decimal and the number formed by the non-repeating digits of the decimal. Okay, so this one in our example, 342 minus 3. For your denominator, you're going to put a 9 for each repeating digit and a 0 for each non-repeating digit. And then please remember to simplify your fraction. Okay, so that's lesson one for week number two of our graded assignments, which is for the week of April 20th. So I hope everybody is doing okay. So until next time, see you later.